Riverside already includes solid recording features remotely with up to 10 participants in a recording. But did you know, and this is a great feature that I didn't know existed until recently, did you know that you can actually upload your own recordings, recorded separately as different tracks, and upload them to Riverside, and Riverside will assemble them into a multi-track recording that you can edit with separate participants, changing camera angles, transcription, and all of the features, just as if you recorded them inside of Riverside in the first place. Let me show you how this feature works. So if you go into Riverside, go to your studio, and then go to Projects and create a new project. And I'm going to upload recordings that I have external to Riverside, myself and my friend Chris Menard, and I'm going to assemble that inside of Riverside so that I can edit with Riverside and prepare my episode. So I'm going here into the new project screen. I can give it a name now. It doesn't matter. I can rename it later. And here I go to upload. I'm not going to go record. I'm actually going to upload an existing recording that I've done previously and click upload. And you have this pop-up window where you can select your files. I can also import them from Google Drive, but I'm going to select and upload them from my local machine. And in here, I have the videos and the audio that I cleaned up, but I'm just going to deal with the videos right now. Chris and myself, I hold down my command key to select both videos of myself and Chris. This is about a 15-minute recording where we had an interview with Chris, and I'm selecting both of those tracks at the same time and click up open here. And this is going to start the upload, but before that, you can see that Riverside detected that these are two files, and it's asking me, are these actually different participants from the same recording session? So they have to be from the same recording session. The file has to be in sync because Riverside is going to assemble them into a multi-track recording that I can then edit just like I recorded them in Riverside in the first place. So you can tick this box. And by the way, if these are not part of the same conversation, don't tick this box because they will end up being the same recording and the same project. So here we go. I'm ticking that box. And now, you know, you can see this warning here. Make sure that each track starts at the same time so that the audio and video is in sync. So let's click upload. And now Riverside is going to upload these two files and start processing them. And this is going to take a while, you know, while it's uploading and transcribing them for free, by the way, and synchronizing these into an editable project that you can then create podcasts from, change camera angles, create social media clips, and all of the features that Riverside already includes for the native recordings. Okay, so let's wait for this to process and I'll get back to you and I'll show you what happened at the end. Here we go. The files have been processed and now Riverside shows them to me under recordings in that project that I created. You see they look exactly like a typical Riverside recording where the files appear there. You can download them, you can edit with them and so on. And Riverside has already created a magic episode for me. It has used my branded kit, my brand kit, which I set up for this studio. It's got put my logo on the top and my preferred caption preset on it. It's created show notes with AI and everything. And I haven't even actually edited anything. It just creates this by default automatically and a bunch of social media clips. It's still working on some of them right now. And you can see this layout here, which I have done in another video, which shows you how to customize that layout. And then it applies it automatically when it creates these magic clips for you. And magic segments, which is a new feature, selects longer portions from the episode and creates a standalone video from it with some interesting sections. So you can see here that the AI has already kicked in. It's found some hooks for me. It's created a bunch of social media posts, show notes, and, you know, I haven't even done much yet. I haven't edited anything. I have just uploaded the files, and Riverside treats it as a native Riverside recording. So if you go to edits in here, you will see there is one edit that I started earlier, but I'm going to go to recordings in here, and from here, you can actually start a new edit with this particular recording session. If I click edit in here, it just goes into the Riverside editor. You can already see it's created chapters for me. So I've got the chapters added. You can see them and navigate on the left side here. I've got the transcript already done. And you can see the two tracks have been aligned just as if I recorded in Riverside. So this is fantastic. If I go around in this edit here, there's no scenes yet. Riverside hasn't created those because this is a fresh new edit. So now I can use all of the AI functionality to start editing my podcast by going to the AI tools in here, and you can remove pauses, filler words, find fluff, which it hasn't found anything because we don't do any backstage or behind the scenes kind of talk on this episode. And you can do magic audio. If the audio has a problem, you know, it applies the AI cleaning, the noise and everything. And you can do smart mutes, which means it mutes the other person when they're not talking. And in here, you can do eye contact with the AI. So all of the AI features are available right here. And this recording was not done in my studio here with Riverside. It was files that I brought from an external recording source. So this is a fantastic feature. I didn't even know this existed until recently when I tried to update the files, upload two files to do a test transcription. And there it was, the option to combine the two tracks into a multi-track edit. And there you have it. I hope this helps. And if you were thinking that maybe you could migrate some of your workflows to Riverside, but because of this part where you may be recording in another platform and you bring the files in, maybe you record in person in a studio that gives you high quality videos, that is now a possible workflow to bring those into Riverside and then continue editing from that and creating your social media all the way to hosting your podcast, which is something that Riverside is now doing. So, you know, I'm very pleased with this feature because it was one of those things that I knew Riverside wasn't doing, but now they do. So I don't even think they announced it anywhere. So yeah, anyway, I hope this helps. Thank you for watching, and thank you for Riverside for sponsoring this video, and I will see you in the next one.